Hello and welcome to Countdown 2019. The heat is really on. We've driven right across Telangana and it is a fascinating and extremely important state. Do remember that the Lok Sabha is made up really of a federation of state elections. It's not just a national election anymore. Each state has more important local issues than national issues. And historically, the final Lok Sabha verdict is made up of a series of landslides in each state. So is Telangana going to be a landslide or is it going to be kante ki takkar? Like all us journalists, you know kante ki takkar.
Absolutely.
Everything is kante ki takkar.
Absolutely. But we usually think it only happens in Uttar Pradesh, right? or Bihar or Madhya Pradesh. But this is
you don't
important.
Even know what kante ki takkar means, and it's better you don't know actually.
It's a humdinger.
Of course I know kante ki takkar, but I'm saying here nothing of the sort obviously exists in Telangana. Even the issues, what you're talking about, Uttar Pradesh, rest of the country, we live in a different world.
And actually Telangana doesn't look like kante ki takkar.
At all.
You guys are giving the end of the story away now. There we're going to build up to the climax.
Absolutely.
Here we go, here we go, here comes the climax. First, let's have a look at the state of Telangana, which we've, as I said, driven right across and we've just crossed over the border. And this is what Telangana's breakup of caste and religion is almost like a national picture. The scheduled caste, 18%, scheduled tribe, 7%, and OBCs, 45%, and other caste. Brahmins, etc., 15%, that adds up to 85%. Now, all India, that's about 80%, so here, 5% more Hindus as such. Muslims in Telangana, 12% compared to a 14.5% average for India, and Christians and others, other types of religions, 3% compared to 6% for the whole of the country. So, pretty similar to the whole of India. So is this a microcosm of what's going to happen in this election? Don't give the story away. Now let's have a look at the foundation for this election. The most recent election, that's in December, not long ago, were the state assembly elections for Telangana. And look at what happened there. If you just look at state assembly seats and their equivalent in Lok Sabha seats, this is what it's like. The TRS, led by the current Chief Minister KCR, absolutely swept the state assembly elections with 88 seats. That actually translates into 15 Lok Sabha seats out of 17. Now that is a landslide. The Congress, 21, that translates into one actually, the way it was spread out. If you add up the assembly votes and make it into a Lok Sabha seat, just one Lok Sabha seat in the December elections. Others won and the BJP, nil. Now, in terms of votes also, the TRS totally dominates. It's an amazing 47% of the vote. That is huge in any election in India. The Congress, 33%, others 13%, and the BJP, only 7%. So votes and seats, there's one party that dominated the election just 3-4 months ago. But 3-4 months can be a long time in politics. But then one more thing happened. In January, there were panchayat elections. And again, the TRS did very well. But generally in panchayat elections, you don't go at the kind of sweeps you get in a Lok Sabha or an assembly. So in panchayat elections, the TRS got 60%. The Congress, 21% of the seats. Others, 18%. And the BJP, just 1% of the panchayat seats. Now, Dorab, 3 months... 2 months, are they going to be indicators or is 2 months a long time in politics?
2 months may be a long time in politics, but doesn't appear to be a long time after elections. I think the honeymoon period continues and there is no reason to believe that TRS will not sweep the Lok Sabha elections. I mean, you know, he'd have to be incredibly unlucky. He swept the Vidhan Sabha, he swept the municipalities, so he'd like to do very well. You know, there's no doubt about that. The only question is how well. Instead of the 15 seats that he got, can he make it 16? Okay, maybe it'll become 14. That is the only issue, I think, right, in this election.
So, Uma, in terms of even doing well in the panchayat elections, and we have seen that panchayat elections are crucial for voters here, even more crucial than Lok Sabha, actually, although we are national-led, you know, journalists. Panchayats...
But But turnout is much greater.
In Panchayat,
the involvement of the people is much more.
Yes.
But also the fact that from 88, the figures that you read out are no longer relevant because half of those people have are already come over to the TRS side and therefore they have consolidated themselves that
much more. What
do
you mean?
More.
A lot of the, how many Congress
MLAs
have switched?
10 Congress MLAs have switched. You have the TDP MLA who have switched. You have had the independents who have switched. So they have now crossed 100.
Right, that's really significant that the regional leader like this is dominating. And as we shall see later, you spoke to a lot of people, asked about Pulwama. They said, Pulwama, we are not bothered about that. We are not bothered about the issues.
Absolutely not. In fact, this is coming from UP to Telangana.
Different country.
Talk is completely different. Also, quality of life, the quality of villages, the cleanliness. No stray cows, it's very different. But concerns are very different. And the important thing is that you have a leader who was actually a UPA ally. He was a Congress ally. He was a UPA minister. But the break between him and the Congress has been so strong that he has consolidated all this vote under him and Congress is left out.
But one thing he did do, and we shall talk to him in a second, we shall take an excerpt from discussion with him, he kind of was brilliant in handing out welfare schemes. And I feel everybody is learning from that. They looked at what happened in Telangana and it's not just giving a grinder mixer. He thought it through. Brilliant, including his son, right?
Absolutely. This Raitu Bandhu scheme, the direct cash transfer to the farmers, that's something that Odisha, then the central government, then Andhra Pradesh, in fact, many states across the country have realized that's something that's working. It's making the farmers happy and therefore they want not just the farmers scheme. You have schemes targeted at different segments of the population, whether it was shepherds, whether it was washerwomen or fishermen.
Barbers, I mean, just barbers. Amazing. So this whole election in Telangana exemplifies the new trend in India of assembly elections and regional leaders. So we asked KCR, what is this balance between regional leaders and national leaders? Just listen to what he had to say about where national leadership is going.
Thank you very much for joining us, sir. And first of all, congratulations on your landslide victory.
Thank you.
In the recent assembly elections.
Thank you so much.
We, of course, predicted it as ever. Mm-hmm. I just want to ask you, what is your feeling about the political and election situation in the whole country at the moment?
My understanding of things after talking to so many senior journalists in Delhi and friends in so many other states, things appear to be very clear to me that no single party will form the government in the country. The results of the elections are going to be very surprised. It will be a fluid situation, definitely. Now, I foresee a situation where the regional parties have to work together and gain a say in the post-poll scenario so that the country will be benefited, a common minimum agenda, common program in the interest of the country and states shall be prepared. There will be a coalition government in the center.
So where will Mr. Modi be in the month of June?
I can state say, not individualistically, but party-wise I will say, BJP won't get power on its own as it was in 2014. They are bound to lose seats in all the states where they gained last time. It's not going to be the same game. 2019 will be totally different from that of 2014. I have no iota of doubt about it. This is the information from across the nation. I have been talking to so many people. Everybody says that बीजेपी के सीटें तो कटना ही कटना है कहां कितने कटेंगे वो देखने वाली चीज है
बट यू आर नॉट रूलिंग आउट ए मोदी लेड कोएलिशन
आई सी लेस पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ दैट काइंड ऑफ अ सिचुएशन
यू हैव बीन टॉकिंग अबाउट लॉन्चिंग एक्चुअली अ नेशनल पार्टी आर वी गोइंग टू सी केसीआर प्लेइंग अ रोल एट द नेशनल लेवल एंड ऑल रीजनल पार्टीज एक्चुअली नाउ गोइंग टू असर्ट देमसेल्व्स नेशनली इज दैट व्हाट यू आर सीइंग
उमा जी कुछ बात ऐसा है These two political parties who claim themselves to be the national parties have miserably failed in delivering to the nation. Miserably failed. It is clear before the people that they cannot come out of the box and deliver things to the expectation of the people. It is clear now. Because 7 long decades have gone by. I personally feel, and so many others also feel, there is a vacuum in the country. BJP and Congress miserably failed. There is a need for a new alternative. That's where I was proposing to establish a national party, if required, with a consortium of like-minded regional parties. I think that is going to solve the whole problem. There are certain minimums which are not understood by both these parties.
Okay, so that was KCR making a very strong pitch for regional leadership in this whole country as opposed to national leadership. And it seems to be working for him and for many other regional leaders. And just look, we've seen the base that he starts on is so strong from the assembly elections to now. And look what will happen if there's a small swing either way. Just a 2.5% swing in his favor, KCR's favor, and the TRS, his party, will win every single seat if you include MIM, his sort of ally in this election. And a 2.5% swing away, hardly any impact. He loses just one seat. So, Dorab, have you ever seen such solid insensitivity of seats to votes? This is he's won the seats obviously by a huge margin.
You know, he won about a lot of his seats by, you know, he won 37 of those seats by more than 20%, and just 13 out of 88 with less than 5%. You know, he has huge majorities, so it would take an enormous swing against him to dislodge him. And this is unlikely to happen, as you said. You know, it's if anything, we see a bump after an assembly election when a party has done well. Yeah. So, you know, I mean, if he had 16 already, 15 already, I mean, he can't go to 19. He could go to 19 if there were 19 seats around. There are only 17. And he's won the seats so handsomely that it's unlikely that there'll be a major change in the final results.
Right. And as Uma was just saying, that a whole lot of Congress MLAs have crossed over, a TDP MLA has crossed over, but 10 Congress MLAs. So we asked one of the main Congress candidates in this election, what's happening? All your MLAs are moving. And he said, it's all about the money, honey. Listen to him.
What is the loyalty of Congress people if with a little bit of threat and a little bit of bribe they can go away like that?
Shekhar, the bribe is not little bit. The money being offered is huge. A person cannot think in his lifetime that he would see so much of money.
Like what kind of money are we talking about?
No, this is very big money. You will surprise if you tell. If I tell, you will be surprised that amount given to our 10 MLN.
So please surprise us.
But I can't tell
you.
I know, because one of my MLA, being same native place.
He's a rich man now.
He's a rich man.
What property? What kind of money?
See, I'll tell you. There's a contractor who became an MLA with the Congress. He said, my bills worth 2-3 crores have been stopped by government. I have no option. I'll go bankrupt if I don't switch. The other person says a major land deal. A third person says 25 crores.
So 25. We're talking about over 20.
25
crores.
Is the minimum.
Minimum 25. This
contract and all, they will get 100 crores.
What is operanda is, in all of the irrigation contracts and machine Bhagiratha so called drinking water project, 6% of the commission collected by the people in power. Now, in the last 4.5 years, this government has spent 1,07,000 crores on irrigation and 40,000 crores on this drinking water scheme, Mission Bhagiratha. This any citizen in Telangana will tell you, they collected 6% commission. They made some 7-8,000 crores. Now but they're using it in politics.
So that was Uttam Kumar Reddy, Telangana Pradesh Congress Committee President. He's fighting as an MP this time. And he says, nothing about a swing. It's just money that made people change hands. 25 crores minimum. So we asked actually, what impact is this having on voters? And voters, many of them said, what's the point of voting Congress? We voted last time and they just switched over to the TRS. Just listen to some of the villagers, what they had to say.
Even if we voted for the Congress, our MLA went and joined the TRS. So what is the point of us voting for the Congress?
So as you can see, switching from one party to another is not just a technical issue. It does affect voters on the ground. People are saying, you know, what's the point of voting for a party that switches?
Also a party which can't hold its own MLAs together. Why vote for that party? So it's a complete loss of credibility and weight. And Uttam Reddy, nice guy, enthusiastic guy, seems to have strong support where we met him in his sort of pocket borough. But really, not a political heavyweight. You know, he's a young man, he's a former fighter pilot from the Air Force. Yes.
Quite articulate, actually. Yes,
quite articulate, but really not a leader, not a titan in the sort of nature of the leaders Congress had in this region in the past. Remember, Narasimha Rao, P.V. Narasimha Rao came from Telangana.
Vice Rashekar Reddy.
Right. So, Congress doesn't have leaders with weight. And that's the problem we'll see also as we explore Andhra. Because Congress has simply not built any leaders in the states.
So, why is that? Why this decimation of the Congress leadership in Telangana?
Already 2014, despite the fact that Sonia Gandhi was seen to have given Telangana, Congress lost its base. They were not able to consolidate on it and then they made some blunders. One important blunder was that People's Front with Chandrababu Naidu, and that kind of demolished their party, whatever chances they may have had here. And two, the mistakes that K. Chandrashekar Rao made and the TRS made, they were not able to consolidate on it at all. And three, the selection of candidates also went wrong. So what went wrong in assembly, they just got worse as the months proceeded.
Because they were then seen as collaborators of a party which opposed Telangana.
See, I do want to make one thing clear. Shekhar is not taller than me. I am just on lower ground. And you're almost as tall as I am. Dora, we needed a shorty like you here.
You can try one way or the other.
Can I make another point? You know, the three Indian states, except in Kerala, are all very, very strongly covered by money power. All of them. There's money all over the place. Whether you look at, you know, and I don't think the other states probably have as much money, but at least you see so much money in politics in Telangana, Andhra, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu. That is truly stunning. You know, it has become an officially recognized business. Politics today is an officially recognized business. It is no longer a profession.
That point that the Dorab is making is that in the southern states, so much money is involved. It's much more than in the northern states. Now, they said to buy an MLA was 25 crores minimum. That's what they said. And you know, they're saying that elections here, each MLA's constituency is 40 crores per constituency. That's just huge. Doesn't happen in the north.
I think it could be a case of people in the south speaking more truth than people elsewhere. Right. I think it's a case of that. But in this case, the important thing is that if this money has been paid out, you made all this investment to actually win over MLAs that you don't need, because you have more than sufficient majority anyway. So this is a winner-takes-all sort of feudal conquest. Right. That, you know, if I defeat you, I take everything that you have.
The allegation of being paid out is made by the Congress, mind you. Yes. Many of these people may have wanted to switch over because there are other reasons, other pressures that work on them that make you have to survive here.
I said carefully, investment made. Investment could be a political office, whatever. The point is, if you already have such a huge majority, what's the point of buying everybody? But I think the point very clearly is to destroy all opposition.
Right. So, but it's not just about money. One thing that, as we mentioned a little bit earlier, just hinted at it, what KCR and the entire party has done is figured out welfare schemes to a T. It's everybody seems to have looked at it, studied it now, the assembly elections, how meticulously each welfare scheme and some freebies were actually handed out, and many people are copying it. Just take a look at some of these, and Uma, you can actually help me as we go along. The Raitu Bandhu, this is where farmers are paid 8,000 rupees per acre in 3 installments.
That's increased to 10,000 now.
Now to 10,000. Free sheep for shepherds. So Raitu Bandhu cash for farmers. Free sheep for shepherds, where you get 20 sheep and 1 ram. So thinking about shepherds. Then there's the barbers.
Right.
Yes, there's modernizing the tools.
Modernize their saloons. I mean, to think of a barber and help them out. By the way, that's could help them in a long-term basis. It could help their business if they improve their saloons. Then there's the fish seed, free fish seed for fishermen. Then, of course, then this is a real freebie, if you ask me, Shadi Mubarak, and the Hindu equivalent?
Kalyana Lakshmi.
Kalyana Lakshmi.
It's hugely popular among both populations.
Right,
yes.
Right. But this is not going to help them in their lifestyle. It's going to be a one-off, but people spend so much at weddings that this will not get them into debt, at least help them stay out of that. Then there's the KCR kit for pregnant women. We saw that, a box, you open it and lots of goodies inside when you're having a baby. I mean, they thought of pregnant mothers
this
as well.
This is something that's actually copied from a Tamil Nadu, where Jayalalitha took care of the pregnant
oil
lady.
And talcum and towels and sheets.
And you have pre-pregnancy amount being given, post-pregnancy amount. So there's a 10,000 rupees that's handed out.
Then there's a pension scheme. That's 1,000 rupees a month, going up to 2,000 or staying at 1,000?
1,000 as of now. But yes, the numbers that are covered are huge, and people relate the numbers from 300, it went up to 1,000. That itself is something they're very happy about.
Then you have land for scheduled castes. He promised 3 acres of land for scheduled castes, but that hasn't worked out and they're really unhappy. But it was a thought, again, target scheduled castes. Everything is so systematic.
Well, the other thing he does is, which is very important, when he announces a scheme, he gives it to everybody.
Right.
So then he doesn't say who qualifies, who does. For example, if he says this is a scheme for washermen, then everybody from that community or caste will get it. There is no checking who's rich, who's poor, who's doing this, who's not.
Otherwise,
doing
that selectively, yes, brings in discontent.
And that's what it does for his Raitu Bandhu scheme also for
everybody.
Farmers. Even farmers with 60 acres, 50 acres get it. Because if you then start selecting, then bureaucracy and discretion comes in.
And also anger sets in. He got it, I didn't get, because I have more.
Then he's announced eye checkups, free eye checkups, you know, for people who got eye defects or whatever.
Kanti,
and then he's even thought about dhobis, to give them washing machines to help them. So they really, really is an important part of elections and government policy in this state. And everybody seems to be copying it. Amazing. Dorab, are you for all this handouts that actually, the ones, maybe not the wedding gift of a lakh, but hand out all these other things that could affect, I'm for affecting people's lives. What do you think?
If they get the money, they spend it and they improve the quality of their lives, it also helps the economy. Don't forget that these are not great savers, they are spenders because their incomes are very low. So when they get the money, they either improve their locations like a barber shop, otherwise they put it into agriculture. They put it into buying goods and service for their families.
Right.
And that increased the demand for those products. So perhaps, you know, it is a viable option. The only concern is that it must, over the long term, not expand in such a manner that there is no money in the budget to pay for it. Telangana has a good budget. So long as it works, it's fine.
No, I think the budget, they can spend less on Parsis and, you know, the rich. Anyway, let's move on. Let's see what difference it made to village voters. Does it affect their vote? Are they happy with it? So we asked a few villages and in towns what they feel about these welfare handouts and freebies.
అంటే
దాని గురించే కేసీఆర్ తోటి సంతోషం ఉన్నారా ఇప్పుడు?
దాని గురించి ఇచ్చింది ఆయన కదా, ఇచ్చింది ఆయన కదా. మరి ఆయన ఇచ్చినప్పుడు ఆయన సంతోషం కూడా పోతే ఎట్లుంటాం చెప్పు.
మరి సంతోషం లేదా దానికి?
ఉన్నది మాకు.
దానికోసం ఓటేస్తారా?
మాకు అన్నం పెడుతుంది కదా.
ఎవరు?
కేశారు.
పెన్షన్లు బ్యాంక్ నుంచి తీసుకుంటారా, పోస్ట్ ఆఫీస్ నుంచి?
పోస్ట్ ఆఫీస్ నుంచి తీసుకుంటాం.
పెన్షన్లు రావడం వల్ల మీకు ఏం లాభం ఉంది?
ఏం లాభం అంటే మాకు లాభం ఏముంది
అంటే, మొత్తం డబ్బులు మీకు వచ్చే మీ చేతికి అందుతున్నాయా, మధ్యలో ఎవరైనా తీసుకుంటున్నారా?
మా చేతికి అందుతుంది.
ఓట్ బ్యాంకింగ్ ఈజ్ వెరీ మచ్ టు ద టిఆర్ఎస్ పీపుల్ బికాజ్ హీ ప్రొవైడ్ అంటే హీ గివ్స్ పెన్షన్స్ అండ్ ఫర్ రైతు అగ్రికల్చర్ ఫార్మర్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో దే ఆర్ ఓటింగ్ టు ద టిఆర్ఎస్ పార్టీ.
పేదవాళ్ళకి పని ఇస్తున్నాయి.
ఇప్పుడు మార్చి చూద్దాం అనుకుంటున్నారా?
ఇప్పుడు ఇక నడవబోయే పనులు ఏమవుతుందో తెలియదు, కానీ కొంచెం వరకు అయితే పేదవాళ్ళకి పని ఇస్తున్నాయి.
జాబ్ రావట్లేదా, ఏం రావట్లేదు, చదువుతా మాత్రం ఏం పాయిదు మాకు, చదువుకున్నా ఏం లేదు మాకైతే.
దానికి కోపం ఎవరి మీద ఉంది?
ఎవరి మీద ఉంటుంది? జాబ్ లేస్తాడు సీఐ. ఇప్పుడు మన పీజీ చదివినోడు వచ్చి ఇంటర్ జాబ్కి అప్లికేషన్ పెడుతుండే, మాకేడ వస్తుంది ఇంటర్ చదివినోడికి? సార్ కూర్చుంటున్నాం ఇక్కడ.
So he says highly qualified people are applying for low level jobs. Where should I, who's an inter dropout, be able to get a job? So I am angry with KCR. Kani andaru KCR kestunnaru kada?
Yes sir, ala endu kesaru manchi
meereyara
sukka mukka vachindi odu vachindi manu yesnam yesa matram em payada undi.
Thinking of the person friends and waste time, they are wasting their, cannot understand.
So they are wasting time with liquor and all that, the youngsters.
Yeah, yes.
They but what about jobs? Is no it job. Difficult or is jobs available?
Yeah, jobs are not available for
not
us.
Not available?
Not available.
Why is that? What is that? You try and get a job. What kind of job would you like?
I like for police officers.
Police officer?
Anybody can not there in the jobs.
No?
No jobs. Oh. Only two members is there. But police officers.
So a key factor, people, is unemployment. They may be getting handouts, they may be getting freebies, and they are happy with it. Frankly, they are happy with it. So others are trying to compete by offering bigger handouts, but nobody's quite matched him for his credibility, KCR and his team. But what actually, in fact, in some areas, there has been a failure of deliverance of these promises. For example, KCR said, I will not ask for your vote again unless I have put one tap in every household and water flows from it. Now, taps have come, but water hasn't come. Maybe it's still to come because we saw tanks being made. Maybe it's going to come, but at the moment it hasn't come. In fact, because water hasn't come and the state government has in fact turned off some of the earlier water supplies, the private sector has moved in. And look at this ingenious way they've brought in ATM for water. Put in 5 rupees and you get a lot of water coming out. Just have a look at this.
Filtered water.
Filtered, good quality water.
Yeah.
ఇక్కడ డబ్బులు వేయాలి.
ఆ డబ్బులు వేయాలి, డబ్బులు ఇట్లా కార్డు. 5 రూపాయలు వేస్తే క్యాన్ ఎంత?
5 రూపీస్. ఒక బిందెనా, ఎన్ని బిందెలు వస్తాయి?
ఒక బిందె వస్తుంది.
20 లీటర్స్ వస్తాయండి.
20 లీటర్స్.
And this is by government or private?
ఇది ప్రైవేట్ ఆ గవర్నమెంట్ అండి?
ప్రైవేట్.
ప్రైవేట్ అది.
మరి గవర్నమెంట్ దగ్గర మీరు అడగరా? ఇది
అడగాలి అనుకుంటున్నాం, కానీ ఏమో ఎక్కడ అడగగలమా మేము అని ఆగుతున్నాం.
అంటే నీళ్లు లేకపోతే పెద్ద ప్రాబ్లం కదా, ఎన్నికల్లో అది ఇష్యూ? ఎన్నికల్లో అది అడుగుతారా మీరు?
అడగాలి, అడుగుతాం.
మరి అడుగుతే
ఇంటింటికి నల్లాలన్నారు, మాకేం లేవు ఇక్కడ. అదే ఇక బాధ అవుతుంది మాకు నీళ్లు కొనాలంటే. ఇప్పుడు
దీని ముందు ఎక్కడి నుంచి తెచ్చుకునే వాళ్ళు నీళ్లు?
దీనికంటే ముందు ఇక్కడ సాగర్ వాటర్ వచ్చేది, అయిపోయినా ఇక ఇక్కడ తీసుకుంటున్నాం.
సాగర్ వాటర్ నౌ దే ఆర్ నాట్ గెటింగ్ ఇట్.
ఇక్కడ రావట్లేదు సాగర్ వాటర్.
వేర్ ఫ్రమ్?
నాగార్జున సాగర్.
ఇక్కడనే నల్లా ఇక్కడికే వచ్చేది.
ఇప్పుడు ఎందుకు బంద్ అయింది?
ఏమో మరి ఇక్కడ ఇటు సైడ్ పైపులు పగిలి అని బంద్ చేశారు.
So ingenious private sector delivery of good, clean, pure water in a village, and it's very successful and the villagers are happy. Private sector, not the government there. Now about freebies, we met a really interesting young man, Pawan Kalyan. Have you heard of him? He's a superstar over here, young film star that has turned to politics. a very thoughtful person. So he's fighting in both the states, Andhra and Telangana. First, listen to what he says about the strong differences between the two states now. They're fighting each other. A lot of the campaign is one against the other. Not this young man. Listen to what he says.
Thank you very much for joining us. It's really an honor to have you with us. You are a larger than life figure and you're working at such a hectic pace right now, and to take this time off, very, very grateful.
Thank you, sir. Even for me, it's a great honor to be interviewed by you and Shekharji.
From what we've been saying, you do films, you're just hugely successful in films, but politics seems to be in your DNA in the sense that you feel you're very idealistic. Are you too idealistic?
For politics?
Sometimes I feel too idealist. Like sometimes even I myself feel, am I being too impractical? But I said, you have to have a kind of maverick attitude to achieve something. For me, I said, what do I lose? I always love to walk into the unknown. An individual goes to any extent to earn money, thousands of crores, I said, if he has the madness to pursue that part to do, create a lot of suitcase companies and to do a lot of scams, if they have that kind of madness, why can't I be the opposite? I said, even I should. They have certain extremity, and let me have this extremity, whether it gives me success or not, I don't know, but I prefer to do the, to tread on this journey, to walk on this journey.
So you will carry on both politics and cinema. I hope you will not lose that great talent that you have in cinema.
Actually, frankly speaking, I struggle to do a cinema.
You struggle?
I struggle to act. I mean, it's a tough job for me to perform because I prefer to be as natural as possible. So if something happens in the same line, okay, this is my performance, then I said I'm fine to do acting. But
do you have a view on Rahul Gandhi?
Rahul Gandhi, I don't know, I think people put him down too much, I mean, they mock at him too much, which is not right. Sometimes I feel, he has his own thinking, though maybe he's disinterested for being like that. I think on purpose, out of disinterest, I think he must be behaving like that, but actually, deep down, I think he has a lot of commitment, that's what I feel. And you can never undermine any individual. Whatever being is being projected outside.
And tell us a bit about your alliance partner Mayawati and your experience working with
Mayawati. With her, in 2008, we had a lot of common who wanted to, apart from the regular parties, there is another third groups, a lot of different groups, they wanted to come together. And they had seen me because they know my social commitment level. They came and approached me, why don't you work for BSP? In fact, though it didn't come from Mayawati ji then, but it came from one of the state BSP leaders. Why don't, if you had BSP in unified Andhra Pradesh, we would like to, we'll give you as a prime chief minister candidate. And I said, my brother is about to start a party. I said, and that will be doing injustice, even if I can't say a contemplator. I said, I'm sorry, I cannot do it. And that's how actually the
started.
And constantly we used to, in 2014, they wanted to some kind of, but there were no local leadership. But one individual whom I trust, he brought a notice that they wanted to meet me. So I went and approached. So it was from the moment I met her, it was a very cordial meeting and it was quite affectionate. And the most beautiful thing she said was, it's not about seat sharing at all, it is about, she wants to see a good leadership in each and every state.
Okay.
And that's what she believes in, and that's how we got connected with
her. So I would like to end with you teaching us something.
I'm
which you have,
this.
Which you are well known for, your gesture. I wonder if this is a gesture when you saw something terrible happening to a woman being bullied. When you see terrible politics, what same gesture? What is the gesture? And how do we do it?
I'm thinking, what I'm supposed to do?
No, but the famous one that you didn't mean it to become famous.
I didn't mean it to happen, it just happened.
So just think of a terrible political scene and what will you do?
I'll have a blank look.
No, this, I want to see this one.
You want to see this?
As Pawan Kalyan, and also what he says is he does not believe in freebies. Bit like Shekhar. Listen to what Shekhar and him say. Shekhar prompting him.
He gets just a few more votes than I do.
just a few more.
When you speak to your supporters these days, you're campaigning, what is the central message and what's the most popular thing that you say? You're an actor, so you must have something that gets people really excited.
I feel, you know, I don't give any my opinions as such, but what is there prevailing amongst them? What they wanted is, they don't want welfare activities. They don't want
freebies.
They said, give us future for next 25 years. Mm. And when I picked it from one of the youngster. So I said, it is not about 25 kilos of free rice or 2,500 rupees. Unemployment payment.
Dole.
Yeah. It is, I'm here to give you, to work for your future for 25 years.
But then people who give the doles and freebies, they are the ones who win the elections.
Maybe every time, see, it's like, what I believe in, you know, Nicholas Taleb's the black swan. Unless someone tries. Unless he does the other way, opposite, then no one believes in it. So I prefer to give that surprise constantly, because I could see this change. People wanted change since 2004. And everyone, and even Mr. Modi, people wanted a change, and that's what they rallied behind him. But BJP might be thinking like they created the manufactured concern, but actually it is not, what I personally believe. The people wanted a change. They've been experimenting with different people, okay, in each and every state. Even here, they experiment with different people, even they tried with me. So I believe, though, as you said, the people who does freebies and rules, they might be the ones as on now. But we don't know. We have to prove an example. That's it. Maybe these elections could be won.
So there he doesn't believe in freebies. Now, Dorab, what he does say, what the villagers said was, okay, these freebies are fine. We are happy. And they actually, it does affect their vote. But they're really, really troubled about a lack of jobs. They're well-qualified, educated, honestly talented, hungry for doing something. They just can't get jobs. How important is that? Or do they see, the voters see both sides equally bad at providing jobs?
I think so, because I think, you know, when you think about it, there are no jobs. There are no jobs. The economy is growing, but it's growing through industrialization, through large-scale capital expenditure. Whatever you do, I don't think there is a short-term fix to jobs. On the one hand, we are churning out thousands or hundreds of thousands of graduates of various kinds every year, but they just aren't the jobs to go around. And particularly, you know, Indians are very, educated Indians are very loath to move, to look for jobs. They want jobs in an area where they live, around the area where they live.
I think that's a bit unfair. You know, we saw a graduate driving a scooter. He said, look, I did qualify, but this is what I've had to do. They are trying to live. And they, as you said, there's just no jobs. Shekhar, here's one similarity between Telangana and the South and the whole country. A lack of jobs. And we're growing at... industry is growing at 2%, 3%. I remember I'm a China follower. It used to grow at 18, 20% in their real growth days. Industry growing at 2%, you've got no chance for jobs.
Yes, absolutely. And, you know, we saw that, say, in Chhattisgarh, state with such mineral resources, but even the plants that were there looked run down. So unless...
Plants meaning factories.
Factories.
Not these plants.
Not these plants.
These also.
These are nice, healthy millets. So when industry doesn't grow, you can't say services will grow and industry won't grow. The destruction of Indian manufacturing industry, you can see it across the board. You can see it in the industrial growth figures. You can also see it in export figures. That's quite phenomenal, particularly at the MSME level, which is the biggest job provider.
This is the medium and small scale.
Medium, small and micro industries. Right. And the destruction of those, and I suggest, post-demonetization has been uniform across the country. Right. So that is something that every state has suffered from. And states like this, which are industrialized, which have a lot of industry already, have suffered even more.
Even bigger is the fact that there are hundreds of, actually, highest number of engineering colleges here. You have professional colleges all being sponsored by the government, funded by the government, and therefore you have that many more graduates
and producing for highly talented, qualified. Highly qualified people. It's a
without
tragedy.
Jobs.
Yeah. You find that everywhere you go. In
absolutely.
Do they blame the center and not the state, or they just hate them all?
Yeah, they blame the center more, I must say, because in many senses they feel that the jobs have not been created, the opportunities are not there. The state government, Telangana promised, one of the biggest things was about giving jobs to the youngsters, and that they were targeting government jobs as well. But how much can the government
absorb? In fact, the amazing thing is how little we hear about national leaders, Mr. Modi or Rahul Gandhi. In fact, you have to prod people to ask them. Nobody talks about national leaders, and very few issues that we in the heartland or Delhi might describe as
I'm
national
from Bengal.
Issues. Yes, I mean, you Bengalis might describe, as because what you think today, we think tomorrow, right?
Quick recovery.
Quick recovery. So there is no mention of national leaders or what is generally seen, say, in Delhi as national problems, because problems are very local.
So now coming back to elections, those are the issues, the welfare scheme, the freebies, the unemployment and various other aspects. I must say, everywhere we went, Ayodhya irrelevant, Hindu-Muslim
cows
tension
irrelevant.
Irrelevant.
Have you seen a stray cows, cow in
not
3 days? Not
cows
one.
Look beautiful, healthy,
yes.
And happy here, you know, compared
they
to what
not
we saw in UP.
They are not
UP.
Floating here and yeah. There eating plastic. In fact, you see much less of that plastic garbage outside villages here.
Yeah. It's a different world.
It's also amazing how many villages have drainage.
They have actually a scheme, fodder scheme even for the cattle. So they are provided with even during the drought season.
Even though cows don't vote.
Well, they are owned by people who do.
In the heartland, Bihar had a fodder scheme once, you know that. Right.
So now coming back to the actual elections, what's going to happen? One of the amazing things which KCR did was quickly advance the assembly elections and did not hold it simultaneously with the Lok Sabha elections. Now everybody said, was this a mistake? Is it a good idea? In retrospect, it was just brilliant. He must have read our book. Sorry, I'm not meant to say that. He would have, it was brilliant for the following reasons. Let's have a look. 93% of state assemblies that are won go on to win the Lok Sabha election in that state easily. In other words, if you win the state assembly election, if a Lok Sabha election is held within a year after the assembly election, you do even better in the Lok Sabha election. You're in a honeymoon period. So KCR and his team must have worked that out. Now, how much better do you do? On average, if you look over the last few assembly elections that have been won and as Lok Sabha elections later, the party that won in the assembly gets 25% more seats in the Lok Sabha that follows. 25% more seats, that means KCR and the TRS are going to get all the seats if they follow exactly historical patterns. But the key point, Dorab, is that not only are you almost 100% sure, 93% sure you're going to win, be the largest party in the Lok Sabha, and you're going to do even better. That's a major signal and shows a great decision to advance the assembly elections by KCR.
Well, I think it's a risk he took, and it's worked out brilliantly for him. The only pity is that he can't go over 100%. That's the only problem that he has. And, you know, whether it's 50, I think the final question is, if you forget the MIM seat, whether he's going to get all of them or probably drop one or two. That's the only thing. And it's really a sweep for him. That's what he worked for. That's what he's got.
So, you know, one thing, Uma, everybody looks at KCR now and his team, and I think his son and daughter and family and other members of the team are really bright at this, and they've studied at the best place all over the world. Everybody looks and says, my gosh, everything he's done has been so scientific. Are they all cephalologists?
He's a very he's a very experienced politician and obviously very, very sharp. He's thinking four steps ahead in many senses, you must say. When, you know, he started the 2001, when he started his own party, he stepped out at a time when nothing was going well for him. And then he's built on it, and within a struggle that happened for so many years, he managed to get the state. Of course, there were other circumstances that led to it. But even after the assembly elections, he has been very smart. He has put his son in charge of the party. He is here, but he is fully in control. It's a state that he doesn't have to worry about, and he's probably very ready, more than any other regional leader,
So Shekhar, explain a bit about this honeymoon that we've noticed. Even at panchayat level, there's a huge honeymoon after that. At assembly, there's a honeymoon after that. But Lok Sabha doesn't have that much of a honeymoon. So these seem to have a reflection on Lok Sabha, but not the other way around, this honeymoon effect.
Well, I would call it the momentum effect.
Momentum, yeah, that's
because
better.
People's minds are made up. And usually, if their minds are made up, say, in a Lok Sabha election, you would see one thing that is quite clear is that in Lok Sabha, by the time Lok Sabha elections take place, if it is two national parties, minds are made up, mind can still change because they may say, I'm voting for or against my chief minister.
Right.
But
right.
If in the Lok Sabha election, they are voting for the regional parties in such an overwhelming way, then there is much less of an impulse to vote differently in a parliament election, unless a national leader is enormously popular in your state, which I would say Mr. Modi isn't.
That political vacuum exists. You don't have those national leaders anywhere. Like you're mentioning that no one mentions any of those national leaders when you're talking about politics or elections here.
And Narendra Modi may have a presence in Karnataka. I mean, he has a lot of support
Coastal
himself. And a lot of people see him as a very strong and a very popular leader, but not in Telangana.
So actually, you put this question to KCR. A lot of people say he may tie up with Mr. Modi and the BJP after the elections. So Shekhar asked him, what do you think of Narendra Modi and will you tie up? And let's hear what KCR himself had to say.
Sir, you have worked with UPA before. Sonia Gandhi. How do you compare Sonia Gandhi with Rahul Gandhi?
Sonia was much, much better. She was with good understanding. She was patient. She was trying to carry all with her. Of course, sometime little before or later, she tried to adjust. She tried her best to deliver goods. She was quite reasonable. She was never unreasonable. It was my experience with Sonia ji.
And what about Rahul Gandhi?
I hardly met him. I only met him once. After that, these days we are brickbatting.
Right. But what's your assessment of him? You see him campaigning, you see his statements.
He is maturing well, no doubt, but he has to mature beyond.
And sir, in one line, if you will tell us what you think of Mr. Modi, your analysis of the political personality of Mr. Modi.
Politically, Mr. Modi is a flop.
Flop.
100% I can say that because he has not delivered.
Sir, after 283 seats,
I'm a live chief minister.
Sir, 283 seat ke baad aap flop keh rahe hain.
Sab aap suniye. Usi ke baad ki baat keh raha hoon.
Acha, baad ki baat keh rahe
hain. Uske baad ki baat hi main keh raha hoon. He had a golden opportunity, as a first non-Congress government, having got the opportunity, he could have done much more. और सबसे बड़ी बात गुप्ता जी मुझे आप माफ ही करना एकदम मैं तो कहना ही चाहूंगा सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि नो पार्टी इन दिस कंट्री थिंक्स ऑफ लिवरेजिंग अवर इकोनॉमी व्हेन जापान कैन डू इट फ्रॉम एशेस व्हाई नॉट इंडिया व्हेन चाइना कैन डू इट व्हाई नॉट इंडिया व्हेन सिंगापुर कैन डू इट विदाउट हैविंग एनीथिंग सर उनका तो मट्टी भी अपना नहीं है दूसरे जगह से मिट्टी
इंडोनेशिया से आ रहा है
रिक्लेमेशन करता है जिसका मिट्टी भी नहीं है जिसको पीने का पानी भी अपना नहीं है वो उनका सरप्लस बजट का बांटता है लोगों के बीच में ये स्थिति हिंदुस्तान में क्यों नहीं है मलेशिया कर सकती है सिंगापुर कर सकती है कोरिया कर सकता है व्हाई नॉट इंडिया
सो दैट वाज केसीआर काइंड ऑफ हेजिंग हिज बेट बट कमिंग प्रीटी फर्मली क्वाइट ऑन रिकॉर्ड दैट ही डजंट थिंक द बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट हैज डन वेल एट ऑल इनफैक्ट इट्स बीन अ फ्लॉप. So he put the same thing to the Congress leaders and say, do they believe him? Do they think he'll go with the BJP or will he come with a different alliance? This is what the Congress leader had to say.
I just want to ask you, for both of you, who is your main opponent? Is it TRS or BJP?
You know, the election, we are fighting it on the basis that the Telangana people should vote for whom they vote as a Prime Minister, Rahul Gandhi or Narendra Modi. But on the ground, it is a fact that the TRS candidates are much, much stronger. So we are also taking the narrative that for 5 years now, KCR has been, you know, an ally of BJP in all the major issues. Whether it's the President of India elections, TRS voted for BJP. The Vice President of India elections, TRS voted for BJP. The Rajya Sabha Deputy Chairman, TRS voted for BJP. Demonetization, GST, Lok Sabha, no confirmation. All of them, the TRS would support the BJP. So we are quite sure they have a secret understanding. Now elections have come, so they act as if they are, you know, criticizing each other. But actually they have a secret pact going on.
What do you say about that? Your main opponent?
Main opponent is BJP, but in Telangana there is no BJP. So ultimately we will vote TRS, they will go to BJP. So TRS is the main opponent here.
Main opponent.
Because there is no BJP in the last election. In 100 seats, BJP got only 1000 seats in every assembly, except 1, 2, 3. So ultimately TRS, after this election, he will go to NDA. That's the main opponent.
Even for the main Congress supporters who voted for you, out of your 19 MLAs, 10 of them have left. Then you're cheating the voter. Then why should I vote for a Congress when they are shifting and they're making their own deals? Isn't that the message that's going?
Kumar, the strange aberration that is taking in Indian democracy in Telangana now, a chief minister in power himself is using his power and ill-gotten money either to bribe or threaten the MLAs to join.
But don't you feel that the schemes they have been successful and popular?
Raitu Bandhu lanti schemes.
No scheme, including Raitu Bandhu also. As per our information, only 50% of farmers got that Raitu Bandhu amount. After 4 months, in December, they got that message through the time of election. Still, 50% of farmers to get that Raitu Bandhu.
Why did you lose so badly in the assembly then?
Shekhar, see, that was a little thing that took us to a surprise too. We are suspicious about many of the things that happened in the elections. We suspect that the election commission, the CEO here, they're not impartial. There was a huge deletion of voters list, mostly belonging to the Congress party. We have serious suspicion on the EVM machines. We have collected a lot of data. Unlike anywhere in the country, the trend throughout Telangana is after 4 o'clock. The huge percentage of voting shown, and after 5 o'clock last time of voting, they're showing a huge amount of voting having been done, which, you know, physically is not improbable. We have filed several cases in the courts. The courts are taking a hands-off approach. In my own wife's case, out of 2 lakhs votes polled, she lost by 600. The norm earlier was if you lost less than by 1% margin, recounting would be allowed. Now they've come with a new rule. You say we won't count the VVPAT papers. Yeah. We'll count the machines.
You want to see the
machines you don't trust.
Do you regret having aligned with TDP in assembly?
No, we don't regret that.
Little bit in urban areas, in centralized urban area, like Alwanda, but that is not major. Because my observation is one scheme mission bagger tha. वो क्या बोले पहले घर घर को पानी नहीं दिया तो मैं टिकट वोट नहीं बोलते अब तक पानी नहीं आया यू एंक्वायर
ओके आई एम गोइंग टू आस्क यू टू डू वन थिंग प्लीज मूव कैन यू डू अ झप्पी ब्रदर्स झप्पी ओवर हियर कम ऑन मतलब मोदी झप्पी
So there you have a national party's point of view versus a state chief minister's point of view. And there's one major, major trend which we must recognize in these elections that will be completely different from past elections. Just look at how regional parties are growing in India over time. Regional parties used to be just 4% of the vote. Then they went up to 17%. Last elections and last few elections, they are 34%, from 17 to 34. That's doubled. And then people are saying this time it could go over 40% of the vote. That is the amount, the significance of regional parties, and they could be more important than any single national party. A 40% vote or above that could be the largest block of alliances compared to any other party. So what another factor that's important is that for regional parties earlier, they were getting very few seats per vote. Now, because their votes are concentrated, regional parties get more seats per vote than national parties. Regional parties get 11 seats for every 1% vote. National parties get only 7 seats. That's almost 50% less for every 1% vote. 7 seats per 1% compared to 11 seats per 1%. That is a that gives regional parties huge bang for the buck. And that's what's making them, giving them momentum, as Shekhar describes the word, and moving them further and further and making them more and more important. And when you talk about national parties, please understand, there are only two now. There used to be more, but just look at the decline of other national parties. There used to be 15% of the vote. That's non-BJP, non-Congress. Then they went down to 5%. Now, other national parties apart from these two are just 1% of the vote. Irrelevant.
In fact, they don't even qualify to be national party.
They're still all losing it one at a time. So from being a significant other, now it's really BJP and Congress and regional parties. There's no other national party.
In fact, I can push this a little bit and say that national parties are beginning to look like regional parties of larger regions. Of multi-state regions.
Right.
So BJP may be of 5. BJP may be UP, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Maharashtra. Right? And Congress, less Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, maybe Haryana, Punjab. So even the national parties are not national parties.
Right.
Congress, in Congress's decline in the south is a very major development.
Right. I think that's one of the reasons for it is that the first past the post system, which we just took from the British, which is a much smaller country, and applied to a larger country, has many disadvantages. If your votes are spread, you hardly get seats. If they're concentrated, you get seats. So all the parties in the Indian Jugaad, we figured out, hey, the Brits don't understand it. Just have your votes concentrated. So even national parties are saying concentrated in particular areas. And of course, regional guys figured it out a long time ago. So this is becoming more a federation of states elections, not a national election. Issues are different. The system treats them differently. They give much more reward. And just look at what the picture of a national federation of state election looks like now. You have these national parties, reasonably big circles. You can see on the left there. And then look at the regional alliances, almost as big, if not bigger. That's visually what it's all about. In fact, in 2019, regional parties could cross 200 seats for the first time. That's a huge change in the Indian political scene, that regional parties are becoming dominant, more and more dominant. And this is an election of alliances rather than an election of, is there a BJP wave? Is there a Congress wave? We need to look at alternatives. The Indian election scene has changed dramatically. We haven't changed too much. So you live in a regional state and you must look at these national channels and say, oh God, they're obsessed with Rahul versus Modi, and that's irrelevant in large parts of India.
That's what is the grouse in most part of South India, that you're always obsessed with so-called national issues just because they're geographically north of the country, and that the regional issues get in that sense short shrift. But the picture obviously is changing, and that's why Chandrashekar Rao is also has been talking about the federal front and talking about the fact that it is now you who has to follow us.
Right. So we asked KCR about this. This growth of regional parties and the relative importance and his federal front, is it really working or is it a dream? And he turned the whole question on its head. Listen to what he says.
One thing which is very interesting and which tallies with what you're saying,
Just a few decades ago, regional parties were only 5% of the vote. This time they will be 40% of the vote. No, neither BJP nor Congress will be anywhere near 40%. 40% will be the largest conglomeration of regional parties. So these elections are more a federation of state elections than a national election. And there's one more thing which tallies with what you're saying. People are more interested in their state. The turnout of voters in state elections is higher than for Lok Sabha elections. So the whole country is moving towards a federation. And do you think that will be reflected even more in this election?
Pranay ji, you are perfectly right. Now, in our country, regional parties cannot be ruled out. Most of the time, the ideas, the rule that they provided, Congress and BJP, were more centripetal, more centric, more centralization. It was not decentralization.
Correct.
So people have now realized that is where people are adopting regional parties. We have seen things happening. Now TRS, in our case only, we emerged 20 years back and now we are a powerful party in the state. Like TRS, there are so many other regional parties in the country.
Sir,
who are very powerful.
You can take all the regional parties, but the reality of Indian
I will answer you, sir. Gupta ji, there was a fashion that regional parties supporting Congress are supporting BJP. Now the time has gone.
It may be the other way around.
It will be. It has to be other way around. Why not the national party support the
regional parties?
Regional parties.
But that happened once. United Front, that is what happened. But sir, the question is that even today, no matter how badly BJP or the Congress do, as you are saying, they will still be the number one and number two parties in this parliament. Either of them will be larger than the third largest party in parliament.
At one point of time, BJP was the single largest party and it formed the government under the leadership of Mr. Bajpayee. And it did not last long.
13 days.
13 days, it collapsed within 13 days. The single largest, being single largest or not being is not the important thing. Majority, one who commands majority. I think the regional parties will command the majority now.
So having said all that, we did ask KCR, does he really want to be Prime Minister? Because everybody says that's what he really wants. Listen to what he said. Categorical.
You are giving a vision to the country. He's a Chief Minister now with 17 MPs. You're saying you're also adding up the numbers from Andhra Pradesh. That number together. Are we going to see Mr. KCR in the Prime Minister's chair?
No, sorry.
There's a good possibility of that.
Sorry. Somebody XYZ becoming Prime Minister is not my motto. That's not my agenda too.
You're coming with a vision for
Very
the country.
Sir. No, our vision is different. Let anybody become the Prime Minister, I have no objection. I welcome.
Are you on the line also?
No, sorry. I am not. My thing is my agenda first. It's not the Prime Ministership that really matters. So
Leadership
many became
matters.
Prime Ministers. Why the country is suffering today? I am straight in my mind. We need to leverage our economy. We need to bring in structural changes. Yes? We need to. There is a dire need in this country to bring in judicial reforms. There is a dire need in this country to bring administrative reforms. Yes, there is a dire need. Definitely. Let us not feel shy to accept the facts. We have failed. Naxalism came. So many isms are coming. People are holding guns. Still we don't realize. What will happen to this country? How long you are going to keep the people restless? It's not good for the country. Let us not play with 130 crores people. We are a big nation. We cannot play with the lives of the people. So I am telling this all this with pain.
So Uma, KCR does not want to be Prime Minister, but he has been working pretty hard on forming this kind of federal front.
He said that on record, but in every public meeting that his leaders have been addressing, they have been saying, KCR is going to be Prime Minister, we will have our say at the centre. And if you are going to ask the question, only 17 MPs? No, he doesn't agree with that. He says,
Jagan is going to make a huge lottery, so to speak, in Andhra Pradesh, and we come together once again. So what if the state is bifurcated? We are the Telugu states and we'll bargain together with the center. So they are hoping out of the 42 seats that Telangana and Andhra Pradesh together add up, they will get 35, 36 at least. And they are saying, en bloc, we are going to bargain with the center and assert our position. So they want a position of power at the center. And even if KCR is not saying it today, for very obvious reasons, he obviously has central ambitions.
So, Dorab, do you believe KCR when he says, I don't want to be Prime Minister?
Do you believe any politician?
Do you believe any?
You know, the question is, I think people, not just Mr. KCR, but other people have made similar statements. But when the push comes to shove, they want to be there. It's a job that nobody wouldn't like to have. The question is whether you have the numbers and the capacity to put a coalition together. You know, the fact that you have 35 MPs, Mamta could have as many for, you know, they could, the Northern Front, the UP parties could have more than that. So, you know, it's got to be how well you maneuver, how acceptable you are. I mean, after all, don't forget Mr. Deve Gowda became Prime Minister and he had no intention of becoming one. So, strange things happen in politics.
So, Dorab said strange things happen in politics. Is there a chance that KCR could be Prime Minister, or is it 1 in 20?
Anything? Lift the layers from our long conversation with him. He talked about Gowda becoming Prime Minister. He talked about many other non-Congress, non-BJP people becoming Prime Ministers. He's not a modest man.
He's very clear.
He gives his opinion of everybody else, which is quite low. I don't think he holds himself in any low opinion. I think he thinks he's smarter than anybody else. And in fact, he was quite happy when we reminded him, or we acknowledged that his Hindi is excellent. So
that could be a big advantage.
Of any regional leader has that advantage. In fact, he speaks better Hindi and Urdu than many other leaders from other parts of the country. Right. So if you have a broken government, I mean, we are judgmental when we say broken government. If we have a government of an alliance, don't count him out, because he's got the age, experience, he's got his age in his pocket, his state in his pocket, he's got his children in place, he's multilingual, and he doesn't really threaten others, because he's unlikely then to grow his footprint into other states.
And it's very clear that people do kind of respect him of the way he handled the last election, the election campaign, the strategy. He's at his peak.
Also, people underestimate his networking. He's very well networked with national politicians. He's worked all his life with national politicians.
In fact, that's a good point. We did ask him that you've been trying to form the federal front and you've talked to many state leaders. What are your impression of each of these state leaders? Give us a quick rundown.
You have met a lot of regional leaders and you're all forming. You kind of talk about how we'll get together and form a federal front. Which are the leaders you have met, and what is your assessment of each one of them?
Maine Mamata Didi ji se mila. She is quite reasonable, she is good.
She is a fighter.
She looks like very ferocious, but she is not. She is a very cool person. She understands, she is possessive, she is composed. She looks like very aggressive, but she is not. She has a lot of understanding of things.
Right.
She has a lot of experience also. She is doing well in Bengal, doing right things for Bengal. I appreciate it.
You had a long session with
Naveen Patnaik. He is also quite reasonable. Surprisingly, when I inquired with people there, everybody says Naveen Babu jeet jayega. Naveen Babu jeet jayega.
And you feel he is a doer also?
Yes, sir. He is delivering to the best of his capacity. That is the reason he has been chosen for the 4 times. And everybody says, everybody believes in Orissa that 5th time he is going to beat the drums again. He will be the winner there, with beyond any doubt. And Mr. Stalin is seen as the hope of Tamils today, the whole Tamil society. After the demise of Mr. Karunanidhi and Jayalalitha, now there was a vacuum kind of thing, but now Mr. Stalin has filled into. Tamilians are having great hopes on Mr. Stalin. I think he will be successful in Tamil politics.
These regional parties, there has been talk about misuse of central institutions. Is it something that all the regional parties are worried about?
It is not the question of worry. Somebody is there, somebody does some harm to somebody, it's a temporary measure, it's not permanent. Power is not permanent with anybody.
पर ये जो raids हो रहा है सब जगह,
हाँ बेहद हो रहा है, नहीं होना चाहिए था.
बेहद हो रहा है,
यहाँ पे एक सवाल उठ रहा है. सिवाय बीजेपी का हर किसी पे हो रहा है.
Right.
सिवाय बीजेपी. Except बीजेपी, कहीं कोई बीजेपी लीडर के ऊपर raid पड़ता ही नहीं है. बड़ा अजीब बात है.
सर वो तो सब
अदर देन बीजेपी एवरीबॉडी इज बीइंग
सर वो सब चौकीदार है.
कौन चौकीदार?
बीजेपी वाले तो उस पर रेड कैसे होगा? चौकीदार
देश के लिए कि अपने आप के लिए?
ये मुझे पता नहीं, लेकिन जो चौकीदार पर रेड कैसे होगा?
आल्सो अदर लीडर्स यू मेट, अखिलेश.
अखिलेश इज वेरी सीजन्ड, वेरी ब्राइट, ही इज हाईली एजुकेटेड, ही लर्न्स थिंग्स, ही हैज एन एप्टीट्यूड टू लर्न थिंग्स. ही इज माय यंगर ब्रदर. आई ब्लेस हिम दैट ही शुड बिकम ए बिग लीडर. आई थिंक ही हैज
अ ब्राइट. एंड द ग्रेट लीडर मायावती आल्सो यू मेट?
मायावती जी आई मेट ऑफ कोर्स. She is with a Dalit philosophy mainly. Her focus is onto that.
Right.
She is also right in her perspective because she is
solid support. She has.
And sir, your best friend Sharad Pawar.
Sharad Pawar is very seasoned, sir. No, but now he is very old.
Right.
Pawar ji is habituated to be with Congress always.
He is not old. He is experienced.
He is experienced. It can be said. Yes, you are right.
So
Pranay ji is always lovely.
So you've met all these leaders, and you feel there's a lot of talent there, there's a lot of hope, or will they be
able to
undercutting each other? That's
definitely, all these people will unite, sir.
They will, you feel?
100% I feel that maybe they take little 2-3-4 days time after elections, but there will be a unification of regional parties. I think this time national parties may come forward to support.
But that critical
good
time...
Good agenda will be fixed.
Moving on to these elections and what affects voters. Most of the surveys show that, as what we've been saying, that Modi and Rahul, not that important, although Rahul and the Congress are more important than the BJP. So when one talks about the Modi wave and the All India impact, you don't see that in Telangana. Just look at what different aspects are important for voter in Telangana. Look at this. What affects the voter and how important are leaders plus their party in deciding who they vote for? Number one, KCR and his party, 45% impact on voters who vote for KCR. It is him and his party. For Rahul Gandhi and the Congress voters, 34%. Of course, apart from this, there are jobs, there are freebies, there are welfare, but the leaders, just focusing on the leaders, Modi and the BJP, only half, even the Congress, 17. And candidates, just the, who does your candidate matter, that affects 13% of voters. Okay, so that is a survey done by Mr. Venugopal Rao from JNU, and has worked with Yogendra Yadav, and we met him, and he does a lot of very hard work in this area. But he was doing this for political parties, but I don't think that affects his bias at all. So the point is, on the ground, and you ask lots of people, Pulwama, Modi, totally different.
In fact, I did a count of about 100 people we've met, and I counted 4 Notas and 2 Modis.
My God.
So really, this is very far, and the impression that you have, there is one dominant leader who will sweep the entire country. In fact, if you dissect 2014, he had not swept the entire country, he just got his votes concentrated in 7 states. And that's what gave him those seats, and you got the impression that one leader has swept the country. So I think times when one leader could sweep the country are gone. The last time it happened was in an unusual election in 1984 under Rajiv Gandhi. Unlikely that this would happen again for a long time.
So that's not a new phenomenon, that except for the Congress, which actually was very dominant here, and we shall see when we go to Andhra, it's just lost its entire base there. National parties in the last 5-7 years, out.
Actually, this was a state that the Congress was very, very strong in, yeah. And they've got virtually demolished where their vote share has gone. It's gone obviously to the regional parties here. BJP, while we are dismissing it, yes, there are pockets of influence of the BJP where they are in fact hoping that parliament elections, they will be able to probably get one or two seats. At least that's the hope. And we have had them campaigning extensively in these states. We have had the BJP president, the prime minister himself, and every leader in fact has come here and campaigned, but the effect has not been there.
Congress still has about 30% of the vote. For them not to be able to build on it, not to discover a new leader in the last many years, since
that leadership vacuum has been a huge issue for the Congress.
The contempt with which they treated YSR's son and family, this all tells you that they are paying for not just misjudgment, but really a great deal of arrogance. And that is the national parties and national leadership's arrogance. Because they, if they fail to see that their regional leaders are also leaders in their own right, they are not going to have much future.
Both these national parties don't have strong regional leaders, BJP right. as well as the Congress.
Quite right, yeah. It's a big failing in perception. So, Dora, the rise of regional leaders, the more and more greater and greater irrelevance of national leaders. Looking ahead 10 years, when you turn middle-aged, Indian elections are going to be very different, and this is the we're on a trend line towards that now.
I think we already see the line in that the two big parties are concentrated across certain states, and in many cases the regional leaders have left the national party to form their own party, whether it's YSR, whether it's Mamata Banerjee. So where regional leaders of national parties don't see a way to grow, they move. If you recall, Mr. Yediyurappa also formed another party, didn't work out well for him. But that is the way a regional leader of a national party asserts himself. Mr. Pawar, Mr. YSR Reddy, YSRC, Mamata Banerjee, Yediyurappa. That is the shape of things to come.
Right. Okay, so on that, we are just going to leave you with a group of students, youngsters, not students, youngsters sitting around a table. We found just on the edge of the lake in Hyderabad, and we said, now talk amongst yourself, what's important, Pulwama, jobs, and we just listen to them for a few minutes to get a real feel of what the young people of Telangana are thinking about these elections.
Numbers have been coming out, they have not done what they have did, what they have said. But when compared to other parties, like Congress has been ruling India before 10 years before the BJP party, the BJP government. So comparing to those, now apart from BJP, whom do we have as a contender for being the next Prime Minister of India? Congress, right? Is there anyone else who will be coming up, if not Congress? Now, what about Congress? When I think of getting their figures, when we get their figures of last 10 years and comparing that with Narendra Modi's tenure of 5 years, we have come up. Let's talk about EWS, Economical Weaker Class Section, so which has 10% extra seats for those who are having income of less than 8 lakhs. So that is going to help those.
That's again like a vote bank thing, right? I mean, isn't that playing on the vote banks again just before the election? Isn't the timing very, very surprising for you that only before the election they've come out with this plan?
The timing does matter, but the thing that matters more is finally it's happening. If not tomorrow, it's happening at least today, right? No, that's what...
For that matter, no matter what a government does, you're always going to say that they did it for the votes. So, everything will probably benefit some person and not benefit someone else. But that doesn't mean they're only doing it for votes. Development is necessary and they need to keep taking such steps.
Sure, development is necessary, but then why just before the elections? Why not when they get elected? You got the question, right?
Sure, this just happened before the elections. Maybe. They did it for votes, sure, but they did it. It's development. Is it development or not? That's my question. They need to...
Let's digress from development for a brief few moments
And let's talk about other figures which have gone up, right? I mean, do you know the amount of lynchings that have happened, the number of lynchings that have happened, only because people are transporting cows, only because people were suspected of cow slaughter, just because people who are not of a certain religion have in their culture been consuming beef. They're targeting them, these people only because of these cow, you know, the transport of cows from one place to the other. They've been killed. I don't know the exact figures, but a lot of people have been killed. Much more have been injured. What do you talk about this? Like, what? Sure, the government is showing whatever development, as you're saying, but for what, you know, like, what are we getting in return? People are so scared now. I mean, people who are not of the majority religion in our country, people who are from the minorities, they're very scared. They're scared for their lives. What do you have to say about that now?
One thing that I would like to ask you, okay, put BJP apart. Let us tell me one other party which would deal with this thing in a proper manner. Tell me another alternative party which is against BJP and ready to serve all these people. It's coming to the numbers. If the numbers have increased compared to the numbers earlier, it doesn't mean that it happened because of him. It might be due to the circumstances as well.
And when it's coming to the religions, fights and all, I remember of having buns all over India during Congress's rule, and it was because of the temple and mosque issue of Ayodhya, Babri Masjid. Did that happen in this 5 years? Isn't that been in control, if not fights, in this last 5 years?
Sure. It's, you might say it's not about religions. I am asking you to put aside Babri Masjid's issue because it's a whole new issue. It's a completely different game. So apart from that, lynchings are still something that we need to think about because there have been a lot of lynching cases and they're actually terrorizing the nation. So that is something that we need to look at, not Babri Masjid.
Okay. Why are we going on the national level? Let's just talk about what's going on locally. Okay, like, let's say, I mean, what do you think the this time also, like, you know, the party TRS is going to come up, right? So how do you think that has been different from the previous party?
Yeah, exactly. Whom do you want from Telangana in the parliament? There will be someone, so it's again TRS, or are we going to take someone from BJP or Congress?
I 100% support regional parties because a national party will not have the same knowledge as a regional party.
True. We can't completely trust the regional parties in all the regions, right? So there are separate candidates in separate regions. So let's just say in your area, the participant from the regional party is not a better guy than the one who is from the national party.
Adding to his question, what if BJP is having a regional candidate, like for example a good person who has all the knowledge about Telangana and all the problems, and is from BJP, would you not support or vote him, or would you still continue to vote TRS?
I would like to answer their questions with a simple answer, saying that politics should be decentralized, as in we should be voting to our immediate leader, that would be the member of our parliamentary section, and not to the prime ministerial candidate. So I think that would be a better thing because there will be a greater reach out.
Well, I will want all of India to be taken up. See, the more number of seats from a single party in the parliament will help in better discussions.
I completely disagree with what you said. I feel that when there is an equal balance, is when the opposition can question.
How will you get equal balance when you have some people from TRS, some people from Congress, some people from NDA and all?
It's called a coalition.
Exactly. So at the parliament, how will you take care of that?
They decide that at the level where they're forming an alliance, right?
You want a TRS member to be there at the parliament, right?
Yes. How many other people will be there from the TRS?
It doesn't really matter, right? Because the party will be aligning itself to one alliance or the other.
So basically, all of us, if you guys agree, we would vote for a person who's more efficient, and the plus point would be if he's from a regional party.
The point again being is,
you agree? Do you agree?
Yes, I agree.
Okay, I would like to get back to the same old topic about communalism. I would still vote to BJP. I am contradicting myself. BJP has been in power since the last 5 years. They have induced a lot of terror in the nation. But I would still, in a way, think of voting for BJP since Modi has been silent on these issues because he comes from a party and he is still inclined towards his party for some issues. So I believe that Modi, if not supporting it, he's just staying silent on it. So maybe there is a chance we can still think of him because he proved himself to be a world leader.
So those are the youngsters, totally different world from youngsters in other parts of the country. And that's what it is. Each state is different and we have to realize that more and more. So we just say bye by looking at this one graphic of the bellwether seats in the state of Telangana. These are the seats. Keep watching out for them. Always in the past, whichever party they voted dominates the state as well. They vote the same way as the overall state, the bellwether seats. Thanks very much for watching. Bye for now.